Let us solve another problem on array fill logic. Here this array has to be filled up in a spiral way. So let us go for the example for the better understanding. So here is the problem for us. Fill up a square matrix having dimension n by n, where the value of n will be supplied by the user, with numbers ranging from 1 to n square in a spiral order. So this is the output of my program. So if I give the value of n is equal to 5, so I shall be having 5 number of columns and 5 number of rows as usual. So here the numbers with which we are filling this matrix is ranging from 1 to 5 square, that is 1 to 25, and in a spiral way, that means in this way. You can find this one, you can read the numbers, you see they have got filled up in this way. So here we have done this in a clockwise fashion. Okay, now at this present moment, just stop the video and try to get this logic implemented at your end using C programming language. Otherwise, demonstration is with you. I'm giving you one assignment in this respect. So try to fill up this array in a spiral way for n by n matrix, numbers ranging from 1 to n square, everything will remain same but in anti-clockwise way. So that means the number will be filled up in this way. Also you can consider this one as the start point, so you can fill the matrix in this way. Okay, so that will remain as an assignment for you. But for this problem, let us go for the practical demonstration and implementation of this program using C language. Here the matrix is to be filled up in a spiral way. Here we have considered one matrix with dimension n plus n, where n is equal to 4 here. So if I write the dimension, it is n is equal to 4. Okay. So here the column numbers and row numbers are ranging from 1 to 4 respectively. See, here as we are having 4 cross 4 matrix, so we are having 16 cells there. So all the 16 cells will get filled up with numbers ranging from 1 to 16, each once in a spiral way. That means 1, 2, 3, 4, then 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10, 11, 12, 13, 14, 15 and 16. So you see, it is getting filled up, this matrix, in a spiral way. We should have to write a program for that. Here, to write this program, I have taken one technique. I'm considering RR is a variable which is the increment or decrement factor along the row. CC is a variable which is the increment or decrement factor along the column. We're having this row variable. So row is equal to row plus RR and column is equal to column plus CC will be our default expressions. Now see, if RR is having value 0, then row will not be changing. If RR is having value minus 1, then using this particular formula, the row can be decremented. If RR is having plus 1 value, then row is getting incremented. So depending upon the value in RR, whether it is 0 or minus 1 or plus 1, it will be decided whether row is not getting changed, row is getting decremented or row is getting incremented respectively. And similarly, the same logic is true for column also and CC variable also. Now see, in the first, we are moving in this way. That means the row number is not changing but column number is increasing. So if I put this RR and CC, the dressing table, then initially RR will be 0 and CC will be 1 because the row numbers are not changing but the column numbers are changing. When I'm moving in this way, that is 4, 5, 6, 7 rather, then you see row number is increasing but the column number is remaining the same. So row number is increasing and the column number is remaining the same. When I'm moving from 7, 8, 9, 10, then you can feel that row number is not increasing or decreasing. Row number is remaining same, but the column number is decreasing. So row number is remaining same and the column number is decreasing. If you move in this way, you can find that row numbers are decreasing and column numbers are remaining same. So row numbers are decreasing and column numbers are remaining same. Again, when you are moving in this way, that is the same logic whatever we had here also. So again, I shall get row number, RR will be 0 and CC will be 1. So here RR will be oscillating in between the series, that is 0, 1, 0, minus 1, 0, 1, 0, minus 1 in this way. And CC will have the value like 1, 0, minus 1, 0, 1, 0, minus 1, 0 in this way.
And in this way, the spiral logic will be continued. Now, see, how to get it? Actually, see, the new order is equal to nothing but old CC. This new order is equal to old CC. This new order is equal to old CC. This new order is equal to old CC. So you are getting a parity here. So we can write in this way that new order will be the old CC, but before erasing the current value of order, I should put it in some temporary variable, let it be TT. So TT is equal to RR and RR is equal to CC. So what is RR? That is the new RR. What is CC? That is the old value of the CC. Now, if you consider this column now, CC now, then it is nothing but, you see, minus of old RR is equal to new CC. Minus of old RR, that is minus 1, will be the new CC. So minus of old RR, I'm getting the new CC. Here also you can find that minus of minus 1, that is plus 1, will be the new CC. So initially the old RR has been kept in TT. So CC is equal to minus TT. So there is a way where we can do the changes in the CC values. So I could have written the same in this particular bunch of statements also. I'm keeping TT getting initialized with CC, and CC is getting the minus RR, and RR is getting initialized with TT. So that is another way. Either I shall be using these three statements or these three statements, whatever required. Now, when this will be applied, whenever I'm filling up in this way, 1, 2, 3, 4, when my target place number is having the target column number 5, which is greater than n, then I should apply this logic. So when C is greater than n, when I'm moving in this way, when my target row number is greater than n, so when my target row number is greater than n, then I should apply this bunch of statements to change the values of RR and CC respectively. Now here you see, when I'm moving in this way, even is coming down here, and where this column number is becoming 0, so now when the column number is becoming 0, also I could have written this one as C is equal to 0, otherwise I can write C less than 1, then the logic will be applied, this initiative will be applied. And another thing is that preoccupied, that means after filling up 12, when I'm moving to this place, I'm finding that it is not initialized with 0, then I should come down here, so the 13 will be placed here. I told you this one earlier for multiple number of times, that if you define one variable, if you define one array above the main, that is if you have the global scope of the variable or the array, then the variable or the array will be initialized by 0. So that's why if I find that the target location is not having the value 0, that means it is preoccupied logic. Because here we are supposed to fill up this array with the values ranging from 1 to n square. So there is no scope of having 0 here. So that's why if you find that if ARC is not equal to 0, then only this logic will be applied. That means it is a preoccupied logic. Now question is coming in mind that whether I should put this limit check at first, then preoccupied logic, or preoccupied logic at first, then limit checks. My opinion is that at first you should have to check whether you are within this boundary or not, that is n cross n. Then you should check that my target location is preoccupied or not. So that's why these three conditions can occur in any order, but it should be the fourth condition in our if statement. So now here we are having this OR logic. So if it is true, or this is true, or this is true, or this is true, then I shall apply these three statements or these three statements. So let me go for the programming. So here we have defined the respective variables. N has been taken from the keyboard as input. Row is equal to 1, column is equal to 1, because initially the first data will be placed at row is equal to 1, column is equal to 1. If required, then we can also do the same with the row numbers ranging from 0 to n minus 1 column numbers, and row numbers will be 0 to n minus 1. That can be also done. It is not mandatory that always will be going for starting with the row number or the column number starting with 1. It is not mandatory. Also, you can write the program accordingly. So here this RR is equal to 0 and CC is equal to 1. So that is the initial logic. And initially we are having this row number is equal to 1 and column number is equal to 1. So I have written this one. So I put this value of I at the A row call position, where I is ranging from 1 to n square. I is ranging from 1 to n square. So now I am just finding that my target row and my target column is pointing to which row and column. So row is equal to row plus RR, and that target column will be column plus CC. So target row is will be equal to row plus RR, target column will be equal to column plus CC. So in this way, I'm getting this target row and target column. So before moving to that particular place, I should check whether the place is valid or not. So I have written all those conditions, whatever you have mentioned, but not involving R and C, but involving TR and TC. Then either any one of the group of statements I shall be using here to change the RR and CC respectively. And after changing, the new row and the new column will be calculated. So new row and new column will be calculated. And in the next iteration within the for loop, at the updated row and column value, the I will be placed. So in this way, my array is getting filled up. Now, this is a very simple part where we are just displaying the array content. So the content of the spiral matrix is, so you know that here we are having this row loop outer, column loop inner, and I'm just printing the respective value at location row and column. And after printing, I'm just making this slash n slash n slash t slash t for the continuity break. So let me execute the code. I think it will make the doubts clear. Let me put one comment here, comment marker. So I'm going for this code execution. It is coming. What was the dimension here? It is 4. So let me fill up it in this way. So we are getting this 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10, 11, 12, 13, 14, 15, 16. So in this way, the things are getting shape. So let me go for another value, say 5. So here the value will be ranging from 1 to 25. So it has been filled up accordingly. Very nice to see, you see, whatever we have planned, it is working accordingly. So if you go for 7, say, then from 1 to 49, the values have got filled up in this particular fashion. So I think the things are now clear to you that how to get such logic, how to do the respective tracing to guess the logic and how to implement the same in our C programming. So please leave your comments below, and if you are having any kind of doubts, if you require any kind of clarification, please communicate with us. We'll be giving you the answers accordingly, and thanks for watching this.